get enough of.
Twilight Pearl. The star of the show. Ladies Wristwear by Seconda. Sponsors ITV Music Specials.
What's your name, darling?
My name is Susan Boyle.
What's the dream?
I'm trying to be a professional singer.
I dreamed a dream in time gone by.
Hard to believe that just 9 short months ago, Susan Boyle was literally unknown.
Was Susan Boyle right to dream a dream? Yes.
I am innocent.
Very nice.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your host, Piers Morgan.
Good evening and welcome to a very special show. She dreamed a dream, and that dream became an incredible once-in-a-lifetime reality. Tonight we're going to celebrate the amazing story that is Susan Boyle's. I'll never forget that spine-tingling moment that I first heard Susan sing at her original Britain's Got Talent audition in Glasgow. Tonight we're going to bring you the inside story on Susan's meteoric rise to fame, and she'll be performing some of her favourite songs with some really special guests. But now, let's discover how it all began.
Susan is a very working class area in Blackburn. A close-knit community. We look out for each other. We always have. Susan's always been part of that. Susan was a beautiful looking girl. She had beautiful black curly hair. She always had the best of ribbons and the best of clothes, and Susan was always the classy one.
When I was a baby, I told my parents not to expect too much of me because I had a slight disability. I didn't make friends very easily. I couldn't trust anybody. And when I did try to speak to people, they made fun of me. So the only escape from all that, really, was music.
Walking out the door, Susan opens her mouth, the jackets are off, they're all sat down. Oh, please, one more drink. Oh, sing another one. What we seen that night on Britain's Got Talent, I've watched that for 20 years.
After Mum died in 2007, I didn't fully register until maybe 6 months after it, when loneliness really set in. Well, I used to find myself crying a lot. I used to find myself not being able to manage, not being able to cope. Although she's not here anymore, physically, spiritually she is. And I know that she meant me to do something with my life, but I didn't know until I applied for the television programme. It was January 21st, 2009. And I was going to be on Britain's Got Talent as an auditionee.
I traditionally don't like doing auditions because I get bored and I get frustrated.
When Simon's miserable, we're all miserable.
We first saw Susan up in Glasgow. She kind of, you know, wasn't really chatting to anybody, just kind of sat alone in the corner. So we didn't really take that much notice of her.
I've seen many acts come and go, and they came through with yeses, they came through with noes. Here it came my turn to go in.
Hello there.
Hello, how you doing?
I'm good, how are you?
A little nervous.
Yeah, sure, no.
Yeah, well, that's not surprising, but, you know, trying...
I got fighting, would you know?
And we just thought, oh, here we go. We've got another one of those. We've got another one of those. Susan was nervous, definitely. She was definitely nervous.
We kind of sent her on stage, and then, if I'm honest with you, our thoughts kind of turned to what we were going to have for lunch.
All right, what's your name, darling?
My name is Susan Boyle.
My knees were not, but I decided, yeah, either show nerves or I get damn cheeky with it.
And how old are you, Susan?
I am 47. And that's just one side of me.
They must have said to themselves, oh, my God.
OK, what's the dream?
I'm trying to be a professional singer.
I could actually feel the audience behind me beginning to get restless. You feel it. They smelt blood. Seriously.
OK, and who would you like to be as successful as?
Elaine Page.
Elaine Page.
God, you know, you can imagine. This one thinks she's going to be Elaine Page. The level of delusion appeared to know no bounds. And then she began to sing.
I dreamed a dream in time gone by.
Within about 5 seconds of her singing, I felt this unbelievable change.
You didn't expect that, did you? Did you? No.
How arrogant were we to assume she was going to be rubbish? And she proved everybody wrong in that one song. It was brilliant, and she absolutely knew she was going to knock our socks off.
It was spellbinding. It was one of those moments when your spine starts to tingle. It was amazing.
That was the moment where I thought, if she can hit the chorus, this song is going to change her life forever. I could feel it.
From the first moment she started singing I Dream a Dream, I was just on the edge of my seat going, wow, can she sustain it? And for some reason, the lyrics of that song seemed to epitomise what she wanted, her own dream of life, indeed her own life experience.
Like a standing ovation. Even the judges stood up. It was exhilarating, and it was amazing. In fact, I said at the time it was, quote, bloody fantastic.
What I felt during and after the song, I don't think I've ever felt on any audition in my life. There was something magical about that audition.
Susan Boyle, you can go back to the village with your head held high. It's three S's.
Fantastic moment that was. And don't worry, you'll definitely get to hear more of that song later. But now it's time to welcome the star of tonight's show, singing a song written especially for her. It's our very own Susan Boyle.
Free.
Congratulations. Fantastic. Susan Boyle, everybody. How amazing was that? It was a stunning start to the show, Susan, but more importantly, how great does she look tonight? Your album has sold 4.5 million copies in 2 weeks.
Thank you. Thank you all for your support.
Susan. I've got to ask you, I mean, you sang about dreaming a dream. Are you still living a dream? Is it reality? How does this crazy journey you're on, how does it feel now?
It feels very real and is bloody fantastic.
Well, look, we're very lucky we've got you for an hour to ourselves today. The whole world wants you. You're here with us. And you're going to be performing some songs. And more importantly for you, I think, you're going to be singing for the first time a duet with a very special lady to you, aren't you? Don't say it. It's a secret, but it's going to be a great moment. Back after the break.
Twilight Pearl, the star of the show, Ladies Wristwear by Sekonda, sponsors ITV Music Specials.
New number 7 Extravagant Lashes Mascara. For extravagantly big lashes. Only at Boots.
$1 million. Fragrance for Men by Paco Rabanne.
Give more for less this Christmas with Currys. Like £100 off this exclusive LG 42-inch LCD, just £5.99. 1080p, 200Hz, perfect for sports. And save £30 on this Samsung NC10 netbook with up to 7 hours battery life and now only £239. Currys, we can help.
You'll find lots of great deals locally at the Cooperative every week. Like this John West Red Salmon, just £2. The Cooperative, good with food.
The band of the Coldstream Guards presents Heroes, the new album. Music to stir the soul. Music of power and passion. Music of heroes by heroes. Heroes, the new album. The perfect gift for Christmas.
More than a million sales later, Dreamboats and Petticoats returns. Volume 3. Over 50 original hits. From a golden era in music. Remember a time of freedom and fun when the music was the soundtrack to your life. Dreamboats and Petticoats, Volume 3, the brand new album, out now.
And you can dance. Like a virgin. Hey!
Papa, don't break your Isla Bonita.
Open your heart to me.
Madonna, Celebration, the ultimate hits collection, out now.
From the divine Miss M comes the Best Bet Deluxe Edition. Includes a DVD of the fabulous stage show Diva Las Vegas, plus the Best Bet CD with 3 bonus tracks. The Best Bet Deluxe Edition, out now.
I love them all.
I'm singing in the rain, just singing in the rain. What a glorious feeling. And then more.
Currys now, we're taking up to 75% off selected small kitchen appliances and personal care products. When it comes to giving, Currys, we can help. Journey away on a cold Christmas day.
Would you like a drink?
To the blazing sun.
Can we get you anything at all?
Where evil's at play.
Like a bucket of strychnine. Would it kill you to call her mother?
She's dead.
Your appointment with Desimother.
David Suchet stars in a brand new Agatha Christie's Poirot. Coming soon to ITV1.
Twilight Pearl. The star of the show. Ladies Wristwear by Seconda. Sponsors ITV Music Specials.
Welcome back. Tonight we're celebrating the incredible story of Susan Boyle. And I want to take you back to when Susan stepped off that stage in Glasgow and her life changed forever. Susan sang, the world listened, and she became an overnight sensation.
Second, the audition went out on TV in England. It got picked up on the internet. It was the equivalent of an internet wildfire. I've never seen anything go like that in my life. Like, bang.
Easily the hottest piece of video on the web in the world.
Now Susan Boyle is one of the most recognizable faces in the world.
You go from the complete anonymity into global superstardom and having 300 million people downloading you. It is, to me, the most extraordinary transformation in terms of speed I've ever seen in this business. Unbelievable pressure. I was getting text messages and emails within an hour of the show going out on TV from China, from Russia, from friends in Australia, from all around Europe. And I texted Simon, who was in LA, and said, are you getting the same reaction I am? This was on the night it first went on television, and he went, it's crazy. I said, there's something going on. Already we could feel it. The reaction was just insane.
She couldn't cope with the paparazzi. That was her biggest problem. She couldn't cope with motorbikes chasing her, journalists undercover in the hotel. These were the pressures that Susan was put under.
Now she had to sing live. She had the world watching. The whole of Britain was closing down to watch Susan Boyle walk to that microphone and sing Memories. And I could tell she was in a very, very, I think, difficult state.
She couldn't quite get the top of the song right. And for any singer, particularly somebody like her without any experience live show, it throws you. And then the first crack appeared.
With no pressure, then having all this pressure on top of me, I found a bit suffocating, you know, as anyone would, because it was such a short space of time. It felt like a bit of a demolition ball, really. I was feeling very anxious during the final. Like, it got so bad, it was actually, you know, sort of staring at the wall and stuff. I didn't want to know anybody, you know?
I asked to see her before the final went out. I just cleared the dressing room. And said, I want to talk to you, Susan. You don't have to do this. She said, Simon, I've lived on my own. I've dreamed all my life about being a singer. This is the one shot, and I want to do this. I said, you're the red-hot favourite, which for me means there's a chance you may not win. How are you going to deal with that? And she said, I still want to enter.
Please welcome Susan Boyle.
Had started off as a bit of fun for her had now become quite scary, and the weight of expectation I think was almost unbearable for her.
Everyone was expecting her to win.
All the way through the series she was favourite to win, and that's immense pressure.
If Susan Boyle doesn't win Britain's Got Talent, then I'm a donut.
And then you get to that moment, it's live TV, you're sitting there, she's in the final two. I mean, you could cut the atmosphere with a knife that night.
The winner of Britain's Got Talent 2009 is... It was electric. Everybody in the studio was on the edge of their seat, desperate to know who was going to win. And then we got word, and it wasn't Susan. Diversity!
Normally, I look at the winners. This time, I'm looking over to my right. I saw a glimmer of fear then. No one's going to want me anymore.
I don't remember much about it after the final. I look back and I know it was tired.
With the huge pressure she'd had, the lack of sleep, the lack of eating, this extremely pressurised week, it all got too much.
The Scottish spinster who became a worldwide internet hit has failed to win the TV talent show that made her a star.
The bookies were celebrating hot favourite Susan Boyle coming second in Britain's Got Talent.
After all that pressure, after all of the attention, to not quite make it must have been very hard to take.
This was the lowest point we'd ever reached, where suddenly you go, we have a responsibility here. And that's the point where you question yourself, the show, and have we ruined this person's life?
I saw the picture of her in the car, under the headliner, the saddest woman in the country, and all this kind of stuff. And I really felt for her. I thought it was an awful, awful situation that you couldn't make her feel better. Everyone kept saying to her, don't worry. You know, Simon was saying, don't worry, it's going to be great. She wasn't having it. She knew that other contestants who had not won these shows just disappeared as fast as they came.
I hadn't eaten properly for about a week. I hadn't slept properly for about a week. I was like looking everything through glass, you know? And the feeling was one of extreme exhaustion.
Go over to Susan, whisper in her ear, we're still here. If you still want to make a record, I'm going to do this and I give you my word. Just remember that.
Let's go back to when I was sitting with Simon Cowell and Amanda Holden on the Britain's Got Talent judging panel. Susan was chatting to us before she auditioned, and she told us she had one very particular ambition.
OK, and who would you like to be as successful as?
Elaine Page.
I was inundated with emails from people from all over the place telling me to go onto YouTube and watch this performance. Came along at a time when the world was a bit weary and dispirited with the recession, and she sort of just lifted us all out of it for this moment in time.
Together, for the very first time, please welcome Elaine Page and Susan Boyle.
Lasts eternally. Perfect situations must go wrong, but this has never yet prevented me wanting far too much for far too long. Looking back, I could have played it differently. One, a few more moments, who can tell? But it took time to understand the man. Now at least I know him well. Wasn't it good?
Oh, so good.
Wasn't he fine?
Oh, so fine.
Moments, who can tell?
It's just a little.
I'm not actually sure who was the most excited there, but it was probably me. Anyway, time for more of Susan's story. After dealing with the pressures of her overnight fame, Susan began to finally relax and enjoy herself.
She was kind of back to her cheeky self, but I said to her, Susan, you know, if we're going to make the record, there's no release date, there's no time period on this. It takes a year, it takes a year. If it takes 6 months, it takes 6 months. It doesn't matter. Just enjoy the process.
Oh, well, after 23 years of a wait, it's hard to be told you're making a record with someone as big as Simon Cowell. It's sort of breathtaking, really. It takes your breath away.
I wanted to make a record which represented her. I wanted her to be able to make a record and feel proud of it, and also have that feeling of you weren't expecting that either, were you? And I said this to Susan, I really, really want you to enjoy this. And what I will promise you, I will make you sound better than even you believe possible.
Now that the whole pressure of Britain's Got Talent is over and Susan now is a singer in her own right, she's beginning to really enjoy it.
She loves being at the studios, and that was maybe one of her happiest times when she was in the studios recording her album.
Seems to me she's having a whale of a time, and I think the more she does it and the more she experiences it, the more she'll be able to deal with it better.
She wants to go and sing as a living, but then come back and be normal with normal people.
My mum's from Blackburn. My mum's quite happy sitting at home watching TV with a rich tea and a cup of tea. You understand? Susan's like that. Life's all about contentment.
Was Susan Boyle right to dream a dream? Yes. Susan Boyle was good for all of us. I mean, she was certainly good for me, because I look at me in that first audition and I saw something which I didn't particularly like, which was incredibly judgmental. So I think Susan is going to help an awful lot of people who didn't have the confidence to do this.
When I looked in the mirror to begin with, I saw this wee wifey with the mad hairdo and the bushy eyebrows. Now when I look in the mirror, I see this sophisticated lady. I think I strub up quite well.
Coming up, Susan sings a classic that moved her to tears when she recorded it for her album. Plus, the song we've all been waiting for.
Twilight Pearl, the star of the show. Ladies Wristwear by Seconda sponsors ITV Music Specials.
Wherever you want to get to, Lloyds TSB is here to help you on your journey. Over the last year, we've helped more than 50,000 customers get a new mortgage and helped over 80,000 new businesses get off the ground. Helped over 6 million people save for what really matters to them. To find out how we can help you, come in and see us. Lloyds TSB, for the journey.
Nina, the magical fragrance by Nina Ricci.
It started with small random gatherings around 30 years ago.
Now I throw an open dinner party each week and around 70 strangers show up, although we do get the odd regular. People always ask how I get rid of everyone at the end of the night. Truth is, I've never been very good at that.
Christmas wouldn't be Christmas without
lots of lovely stuff delivered to your door, eh, Gromit?
Christmas wouldn't be Christmas without your M&S.
This Christmas, the priests invite you to join them in harmony. Their breathtaking new album includes Amazing Grace, Silent Night, and You'll Never Walk Alone. The Priests, Harmony, out now.
I know you don't exactly look forward to my work functions, and I know you don't like it when I beat you. So I know you'll love this. And now there's up to 60% off Philips shavers.
Black Excess. Black Excess for her. Fragrances by Paco Rabanne.
This is Motown 50 Love. A brand new album of the world's greatest love songs. Fall in love with Motown this Christmas. Motown 50 Love. The brand new triple CD. Out now.
The Royal Variety Performance this year is hosted by King of Comedy, Peter Kay.
Hello, everybody!
With Bette Midler. Diversity. Lady Gaga. And Michael Bublé. The Royal Variety Performance, Wednesday at 7:30, ITV1.
Twilight Pearl, the star of the show. Ladies Wristwear by Seconda sponsors ITV Music Specials.
Welcome back to the Susan Boyle story. Now, it's every performer's dream to conquer America, the ultimate land of opportunity and the hardest to crack. For Susan, who'd never even been there, it seemed like a dream too far. But how wrong was she?
We love you, Susan!
Oh, I could hide neath the wings.
Susan Boyle hitting America was literally like a hurricane. Thing to the Beatles mania of the 60s returning to America. It was unbelievable.
And it's the whole American dream thing as well. They applaud success here.
So we thought there'd be a couple of people, you know, taking a picture when she arrived. And then I saw the picture.
She's beautiful. How amazing was that on a scale of 1 to 10? Not that they're used to that kind of reception.
I was blown away.
It's a bit surreal, doesn't it? I mean, one minute you're in the kitchen, second, the next minute you're in America. I mean, it does seem a bit whirlwindish. The warmth was just unbelievable. I mean, it's just so good to be there.
It's triumph over adversity. It's the underdog coming out on top, and it's a Hollywood movie. It's a Hollywood script. This.
Hey, get it down. Write it down.
The amount of fan mail I get is phenomenal, and that means I'll have a lot to me because well, being a performer is very important. And some of the letters are very very touching.
This is for you. This has the 163.
That's nice.
Susan Boyle makes me feel wonderful. She is, to me, what life is all about, or what life should be about.
It's a little bit like an addiction, but it's a great addiction. It really brightens up my life. She's brought happiness into my life.
A
I think Susan means there's no time limit on your dreams. As long as you can dream them, you can do them. So don't give up. Keep trying.
Hello, Susan!
Hello, Susan!
Hello, Susan!
Hello, Susan!
Hello, Susan! Hello,
Susan,
boy!
Hello, Susan!
I read that when you were growing up as a little girl, one of your idols was Donny Osmond.
I was daft about the Osmonds, everybody was, you know, especially Donny.
Susan Boyle.
Hello, Donny. How are you?
Has it sunk in yet that you are an international superstar?
It hasn't really sunk in yet, though. It seems a bit unreal at the moment. I'm learning slowly. I'm learning slowly.
Because you're too sweet. I'm innocent.
Very nice.
Aw. So are you.
Ooh.
It was lovely to see her on America's Got Talent. It was really a really proud moment for us to see her on there doing that song. And she blew them away.
Now, this is the biggest summer show in America. When she walked out, I couldn't believe it. The audience went up as one, cheering, screaming. And in the middle of it, Susan. I thought we are now seeing the blooming of this woman from talent show contestant with a great voice to a genuine world star.
America, give it up one more time for Susan Boyle.
I think she could become, or will become, the biggest selling recording artist this year. And I'm talking about around the world. That is the significance of Susan Boyle right now. And it's all about her.
10 years ago, Susan saved all her money to record a favourite song of hers. 1,000 copies were made and sold for charity. And that record has now become, perhaps understandably, a hot collector's item. Singing that haunting classic, Cry Me a River, ladies and gentlemen, Susan Boyle.
Just to prove that you do. Well, you can cry me a river.
Come on here. Susan Moore, everyone. Now, Susan, even by your standards, the last 2 weeks have been crazy, haven't they? Did you ever think it could come to this?
Well, the answer there would be no, because it was totally unexpected. All I want to do at this stage is to thank everyone here for their support.
Well, Susan, you sang about dreaming a dream, and I think it's fair to say you've now realised that dream. And I think to celebrate that, we'd like to give you a little treat, a little surprise for you, which is that every artist in history... in recognition of your astonishing achievement in selling over 1 million records, the triple platinum record, very few artists in history have done this. Susan Boyle, you dreamed a dream. This is the dream come true.
Congratulations. Congratulations. Take it.
When we come back, Susan will perform the song that made her a star and sing with some remarkable special guests. Coming back soon.
Twilight Pearl, the star of the show, Ladies Wristwear by Seconda, sponsors ITV Music Specials.
Bacardi Mojito, the original mojito.
Have yourself a Merry Christmas with Cheryl Cole and her dazzling album, Three Words. I love you. Three Words, the number one album from Cheryl Cole.
Add a bit of spice to your lunch break with a KFC Hot Rods box meal. A fiery hot rod, cool herb sauce, fillet burger, fries, side and drink for only $4.89.
Time can't erase the memory of these magic moments filled with love.
4 a.m. our van on its rounds, bringing Cathedral City to the shops in the towns. After Dalston to Heathrow via Westminster Abbey, it's a heartwarming sight for the clocking off cabbie. They chop and butter as fast as they're able. White, brown and wholemeal, roll, bun and bagel. The kids have moved out, but they've popped back for dinner. The washing up says cheesy bake was a winner. From Falkirk to Falmouth, from Runcorn to Ripon, bringing the nation's favourite to the fridges of Britain.
Iceland's fantastic range of seasonal vegetables. Baby carrots, button sprouts with bacon, and roast potatoes, all only £1 each.
Share the music this Christmas with The Soldiers, Coming Home for $9.99. Give the music you love to the people you love. Love Christmas, HMV.
Feels like home to me. Feels like home to me. Feels like I'm all the way back where I belong.
Richie Richie, the new mischievous fragrance by Nina Richie.
You don't need longer than this commercial to make a perfect Bacardi Mojito. New Bacardi Mojito, ready to serve.
Twilight Pearl, the star of the show, Ladies Wristwear by Seconda, sponsors ITV Music Specials.
Welcome back. So we've seen Susan conquer America, go platinum with her debut album, and she's truly living the dream and looking to the future.
Susan Boyle made chart history tonight with the fastest-selling debut album since records began.
I've waited so long for what I really wanted.
The 48-year-old's first recording outsold the rest of the top five albums combined.
I've dreamed about this for 23 years.
Her incredible rise to fame has translated into top-of-the-chart success.
You've realised that it's all worthwhile. That's driving so many years. Has been worthwhile.
Maya?
Absolutely fantastic. Welcome home.
Thank you very much.
She is a fairy tale and she's had a happy ending. It's incredible.
I dream about security. I dream about maybe one day finding the right person. Continuing really to make people happy. Drag
me away. It's a great human story, without any hype or without any tricks. It's all about her.
It's because of her story and because of everything she represents that she made it as far as she did, as well as obviously being able to back it up with that great voice. It's a typical Cinderella story.
She just displays there's hope for us all, you know, no matter what stage of life you're at, no matter
where you live,
yeah,
what you look like, you know, where you're from, it can still happen for you if you believe in it and you've got the talent, and she's the best example. Mm.
Susan Boyle is here to stay, and she's here to stay with a smile on her face, and that we now have the happy ending that nobody thought she'd have. Now, isn't that a story?
No one's actually owned I Dreamed a Dream until Susan Boyle captured our hearts.
I used to be a kind of spectator, looking outward at the world. But now I'm part of that world, very much part of the big bad world, if you like. And although frightening, I now embrace it. Because I feel a bit more confident within myself now, more able to take part in the dream.
The Susan Boyle story is one of the greatest in show business history, and I feel very proud to have played a tiny part in it. But there was one song that started it all off, and only one song that we could possibly finish with. Les Miserables is the world's longest-running musical and has been seen by nearly 60 million people. Susan chose to audition with one of its most memorable songs, I Dreamed a Dream. And with her wonderfully unexpected and uplifting performance, she found a place in all of our hearts. And here she is, fulfilling her lifelong dream with the London cast of Les Miserables.
Place with me.
The time is now. The day.
lost themselves, they love.
What a man and not, catch him as they fall. Never know you're not when there's a free for all. Here a new dip, there a new touch. Most of them are gone to sell them when this starts.
One, two, three, four.
My place is here, I fight with you. Night with a voice as soft as thunder.
you're feeling. Susan Boyle.
I couldn't have done it all without everyone's support. Thank you very much.
Is an incredible story, isn't it? And this week, see how Britain's Got Talent winners Diversity got on at the Royal Variety Performance. It's on Wednesday at 7:30 here on ITV1. Well, next this evening, spend the night in with Cheryl Cole and some of her musical heroes, including Rihanna and Alexandra Burke, over on ITV2.
Sponsored by Seconda.
An insight into resident choreographer at the Royal Ballet, Wayne McGregor, is the subject of tonight's